वेलकम ऑल माय आई पूजा हेगाजे. टुडे वी आर डूइंग द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ मॉड्यूल 4 दैट इज अल्टरनेटिव रूफिंग सिस्टम्स. अंडर अल्टरनेटिव रूफिंग सिस्टम्स वी हैव कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ फिलर स्लैब्स, कंपोजिट बीम पैनल रूफ्स, मेसनरी वॉल्स एंड डोम्स. सो लेट अस टेक अ लुक ऑन फर्स्ट पॉइंट दैट इज द फिलर स्लैब्स. अ फिलर स्लैब is an alternative slab construction technology where part of the concrete in the bottom of the slab is replaced by filler material. You can have and look over this image. The basic principle is that the concrete in the bottom half of the RCC slab is structurally not required as concrete acts as compression material which is required in top half portion of slab. So this portion of concrete is replaced by low cost lightweight filler material like Mangalore tile, clay pots, etc. You know, in the analysis of beam you have seen the tension is at the bottom side and the compression is on the top side. So in the tension side, since concrete is weak in tension, we add reinforcement in that part. Similarly, when slabs are casted, the top side undergoes the tension part and the bottom side the top part undergoes the compression and the bottom undergoes the tension. Since concrete is or the property of the concrete is to have the compression values, therefore in that part concrete is not needed. Therefore we can replace that amount of concrete with some other material that acts or gives the same role as the concrete that would be present in that compression site. The image that is shown for you over here is the reinforcement of a slab construction. Once the shuttering is done, the reinforcements are laid in grid form. The size of grid depends on structural design and size of filler material. For example, a grid of 35 by 50 centimeter is used for Mangalore tile as filler material, and grid for 45 by 45 is used for clay pots of 40 centimeter filler. The filler material is soaked in water before casting so that it does not absorb water from concrete. Then the slab is casted with cement concrete similar to traditional concrete slabs. So in the image that is shown, this is the typical reinforcement. And the spacing depends upon what type of filler material you are going to use. Some of the example is, here the filler material that is being used is the cut portion of the clay. You have to provide some amount of offset for that clay material. The image shows the spacings between two reinforcementing ties. And the offset being given. Next, this is the procedure of casting the filler slab. Once in this image, you can see all the reinforcement is being laid, the beam construction is being done, the beam reinforcement is done, and then the casting of the slab is done similarly like the normal casting. Next, here you can see once the strength is gained and the formwork is removed from the bottom side of the slab, you can see how that filler material gives both the artistic view for the roof slab. It not only gives the artistic view to the roof slab, it also provides an insulating material by reducing the heat being transferred from the top of the roof. Some of the advantages of using filler slab is concrete required in this technology is about 20% less than the conventional slab construction. As you know, since we are creating that void, that void would be filled with concrete if you would not use this filler material. Therefore, we are reducing that amount of concrete. Then, due to the reduced concrete, self weight of the slab is also reduced, and thus 30% less steel is required without compromising the strength of the slab. Filler material should be inert. It should not react with concrete or steel. The filler material is that either you are using the Mangalore tiles or the pot, that is the cut pots. It should be inert. It should not react with concrete or steel. It should be lightweight, low cost, and preferably locally available. Size of filler material should be such that it fits the bottom half of the slab and structural grid of reinforcement. Using material with good thermal insulation properties like clay will provide thermal comfort inside the room. The filler material will be seen as a part of ceiling, so shape and finish of the material should be as per aesthetics. So this gives an moreover and good aesthetic view for the construction. Now these are some of the examples or different types of filler blocks. This is on the roof side. Here this is a cross section for filler slab with Mangalore tiles. So these are your tiles, and the dots represent nothing but the tension steel. The spacings provided between two tiles is as shown, that is 65 mm, and the size of the tile is 230. Next one, this is a typical cross section of mud blocks being used as a filler slab. Here also you have the same. The mud blocks are inverted so that the gap that is present over here, when seen from the inside of the room, gives a good aesthetic view.